part of it. Look us up on the web at theworkfm.org or like our Facebook page, The Work FM. You can also leave a message at the station by calling 804-464-1089. Come make radio happen with us.
Wash your hands, avoid sick people, and touching your face. There are everyday actions to help prevent the spread of respiratory diseases. Visit cdc.gov/COVID-19. Brought to you by the National Association of Broadcasters and this station.
Listen to WRWK 93.9 FM on your radio or stream us online at www.theworkfm.org. We are also on Facebook. WRWK broadcasts to Midlothian, Chesterfield, and Richmond.
WRWK is a locally owned and operated non-commercial community radio station. Check us out and join the conversation.
Hello, hello, and guess what time it is, folks? It is time for Elizabeth Charity. Take it away, Liz.
Thank you, Ron. Hey, today we will be doing a second part on the hidden victim of domestic violence. Last week, you met the family of the children, the young or the teenagers that were in the office where she had survived domestic violence. And today we're going to share with you how you can break that cycle of domestic violence if you're suffering from that or any kind of cycle just by redirecting your life. As you know, the family was the mother. She was the survivor of domestic violence, and then she also had three children. And guess what? She is now leading a very successful life. She is a nurse, a wife, a mother, and an author. But what is so important is she and her family is breaking the cycle of domestic violence. And one of the tools is positive family activities. They have fun together with a positive family curriculum. They go to church. And the girls are learning their value as young women by the positive role model that their mother is portraying. Last week, we shared with you that most of the time when a mother has been battered by her husband or by her friend or boyfriend or even by her father, most of the time, the children, they will also find mates who does the same thing because they believe that is the norm. But not this family. In fact, off air, I talked with the mother, and the mother was sharing with me how her daughters taught her so much just by loving and caring for her, even as a mother, because of the positive role model that she was doing. And if there's anyone who's under the sound of my voice this evening, if you have experienced domestic violence and have came up with a solution, living a better life, give me a call and share with the radio audience how you can be able to make a better life for your children and your family. It was Sierra and her sister, Niaja, last week, and they was talking about what the different things they were doing. And one of the things that they are doing now is they are taking it to the community, and they are inviting their friends to come a part of what we're doing here at the Shep Bus. And one of the things that we do is provide solution to negative influence. So what are they doing? They are right now out in the community and they are practicing dancing. Yes, they have their own little dance team. And they and their friends have had the opportunity to participate in, as I said, out in the community, working with other young people to teach dance dance. And they have been in parades. They have received a lot of attention, positive attention, from their dancing lessons and from their dancer participation. The person who started this is Coach Charman. Coach Charman is working with a group of young ladies and the age range from 2 to 14 years old. She and some of the students, they'll be calling in. But in the meantime, let me share some important facts with you. The importance of dance in childhood education. And this is, of course, by Dr. Murray Dow. And it was an update by in August the 15th, 2018. Teachers and parents encourage children to sing and draw. But the importance of dance is often overlooked. Introducing dance to children starting at an early age support creativity, socialization, cognitive connections, and physical coordination. I believe that come under recreation. And it also can be able to be used as entertainment. Because dance expressions are unlimited, preschoolers find great joy in letting themselves loose and moving their bodies to music, freestyle. Dancing can be used as a therapy as well. It's a way of, as we say, shaking it loose, just getting rid of all that anxiety and stress. As children mature, more structure and age-appropriated lessons can be presented, such as math, dance, and other disciplines can be integrated into a lesson plan as an alternative to traditional single-subject teaching methods. Let's understand the importance of dance. Have you ever seen a baby? I mean, this baby can't talk. This baby can't even walk. But if you walk up to her and start moving your body, guess what? She would be listening to the music and she'll spontaneously start moving her body as well. That's how we can communicate. And I believe that's a very positive way of communicating. That is tapping a child into a child's natural fascination with dance simulates. It also has a way of easing that brain. They said dancing has a way of touching that spot in your brain, the neurological growth. And through connected learning, children in dance classes learn to imitate and follow direction. Why? Because they like the movement. They like the move. They like the energy that you can draw from each other. And even when you go out on the floor and there's dancing like swing dancing and all the kind of dancing, most of the time you're dancing when you're happy, right? You want to bring about a connection with each other. So I know I just love to dance. And I'm pretty sure you out there who listen to me, I bet you love to dance too.
I dance all the time.
You do?
And Sandy does too.
Do you? What kind of dance you do, Ron?
I do kind of a, what they call thrash dance. I just kind of dance.
Just let your body move.
I just move to the music. Mm. Not like they do in the mosh pits, but you know, I just kind of flow with the music.
Do you? It has a way of making things seem lighter, brighter, right?
Yeah, it's an expression, and it's fairly benign, and mm-hmm. it's you can do it in the tranquility of your own home.
Mm-hmm.
You don't need any guidance or judges or even a partner, although it's really nice to have one.
Mm-hmm. And it's like it's an emotion expression.
Yeah.
Okay.
Motion is the emotion, after all, I mean, to some degree. Motion sets you free in mm-hmm. a lot of ways.
Mm-hmm. So it's like therapeutic.
It externalizes your emotions, which are frequently very internalized.
Mm-hmm.
So it's a therapy in and of itself.
Yeah, yeah. You know, children who don't like to play competitive sports
mm-hmm.
still like dancing, they enjoy dancing. Was help them improve their coordination, mm-hmm. balance, their fitness, strength, endurance, and self-image. You know, you were saying that you don't have to dance out. You can do it in the privacy of your own home.
Yeah.
Have you ever got in the mirror and just dance and watch yourself dance in the mirror?
Occasionally, when I'm trying to figure out a new step, I might do that. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
But by and large, I really don't care how I look.
You're just being free.
Yeah, I'm just expressing mm-hmm. something.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. It's a good stress reliever too. You know, when you go in and as if you are, it's just having trouble with some things that is going on in life. Go out and just dance and just have a good time. And it's sort of like take your mind off of things that is going on. It can be modified and adapted to students with development or physical disabilities as well. This encourages socialization and artistic expressions. So dance have a language of its own. So let's sort of explore dance as an art. Including dance in the school curriculum contributes to a well-rounded education. So that means that it's a part of education as well. Teachers can help students recognize the importance of dance as an art form by explaining how every culture uses dance to express culturally situations like feelings, belief, experience, and worldviews. For instance, like you go to Africa, they have their own dance. There's most of it with the drums, right? Ron, they beat with the drums.
Mm-hmm.
In Africa, they have the movement that sort of like help bring about rain if they need. No, that's with the Indians.
Well, I think they all have dances for different things that they really need from the world. And who knows, if nothing else, it gives them a chance to collectively say, yeah, be nice they have rain. You know, if DC had to do a rain dance to get missile money, they might be a little better dancers, if nothing else. or maybe to break domestic violence cycles. Can you see that?
But no, this is what I'm saying. Instead of they out there shooting each other up, maybe they should have danced where we can be able to express express ourselves through the steps. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, no, exactly.
Instead of we getting a lot of guns together, and I don't know, but some cultures might not think that's a good idea to get those guns, you know?
Well, you know, guns have only one job, and they're really good at that job. But the question is, does that job need to be done everywhere, mm-hmm. every day? I would suggest... Guns are kind of like smoking. You couldn't get people to say guns bring peace unless you spent billions of dollars convincing them.
Mm.
It's like smoking. Who would ever think about putting something in their mouth and inhaling the smoke? I mean, it takes billions of dollars of advertising to make that idea seem logical. But that's, I think, what's happened to our gun people. People need guns for reasons that guns exist, and they have a limited span of reasons you can use them. They're not really a one-size-fits-all kind of a solution provider.
Mm-hmm. Hey, you know what? With the gun, the only thing you have to use is your finger.
Yeah, it's kind of a lazy man's way to fix nothing but to stop everything.
Yes.
You can make it a bumper sticker out of that, I suppose.
Yes, but with dancing, it's, you move your whole body, and you be stimulating your mind and your brain as well.
Yeah.
And I can see why people can use that as a part of healing instead of as a weapon.
Yes, it's definitely, it's something that you can do. You don't need a practitioner to help you. You can just do it.
Mm-hmm.
And if you're feeling uptight, you can relieve some of that feeling. You could get a gun and go shoot something, but...
That uses no imagination.
That's for lazy people, yeah.
That's not using any imagination at all. That's only just using, as I say, use your finger to pull the trigger, right?
Yeah, that's why more people are killed by accident with guns than they ever intended to kill with guns.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
But still, enough advertising makes it seem plausible that guns bring peace. In very limited situations, they do. But peace is not kept except by learning to get along.
But I was thinking also when they said that guns are used at peace, it's when you're having a party. Now, it would be much better to say out on the dance floor and dancing and getting rid of your frustration and still coming into the party with guns and getting rid of your frustration.
Well, you know, the funny thing about frustration is guns never actually relieve frustration. They give people who don't really understand how to make change a way to stop the things they dislike.
Mm-hmm.
They don't start things. They'll never start things. They're just a stopper. And if you don't have any ideas what to do, I guess... It's a phase at least you'll pass through when you're trying to figure out what to actually do that makes a difference. But if you look at the people that create the world we live in, the parts we like, mm-hmm. they didn't get there by shooting it up.
No, they didn't. They did that through their own creativity, through an expression of what they feel, like art, which is why we said dance is like an art.
Mm-hmm.
It's like painting. Most of the time, and I realized this, how would shooting a gun have the effect on your brain?
Well, I think if you feel powerless, that particular part of the population that feels powerless because they don't really know how politics works, and they're susceptible to ads of insecurity and powerlessness, then they'll go to that as their, or you might say their security blanket.
Mm-hmm. Quite interesting how we just took dancing and art and music and compare it to shooting a gun. Maybe if we can get more people to realize how guns does not really solve anything, whereas art and music will, and it will stimulate your imagination. We will have less domestic violence.
Yeah. Well, you'll have to find out why people are selling violence in society, and they do. Violence and sex are used to sell political issues and mm-hmm. even products.
Mm-hmm. Mm.
It's not natural, but it's possible. I mean, people fall for it.
Mm-hmm.
Bottom line is people fall for it.
Mm-hmm.
I was out there in January when 22,000 people carried their guns and said, I need this gun for my personal safety. I can't mm-hmm. go in the General Assembly building because somebody might hurt me there if I don't have my gun.
Mm-hmm.
It has never happened that somebody's been hurt inside the General Assembly with a gun. But still people live under this idea.
It
takes a lot of advertising.
And just think of how many lives are being destroyed.
Yeah.
Whereas, as said, using dancing like any other form of art, dance is created, performed, experience, and critique. Studying, practicing, and observing dance in society to help children understand art as a medium for selling stories through movement in time and space. Isn't that something? How that goes, you know? You can either have your child to come a part of the solution by creating, by using their whole body. You know what I'm saying? Using their whole body as a part of the solution, even the getting rid of their feelings, you know. It can even use as part of what we was last week, we was talking about bullying. And when you're bullying, you know, you see what I'm saying? And if a group of you are dancing together, I don't think it'd be very easy to bully each other.
Right.
Might not even occur to you.
Huh?
It might not even occur to you to bully.
And dancing feels good. You feel good while you're dancing.
Yes, you feel real good while you're dancing. Older students may enjoy debating the question on whether dancing is an art or a sport. Or possible both, since professional dancers train like athletes. Isn't that something?
They can really do some dancing.
They really can. But see what I'm saying? In other words, that's a healthy debate where bullying is not. And this is a way in which we are seeing as a way of being able to stop that education pipeline to jail. See all the creative ways that we can encourage our young people to get involved with these kind of activities instead of the activities that's causing that pipeline to jail or domestic violence. So guess what? We can also put math with dance. Known as the art integration, innovative, teachers can use dance to explain mathematics. Yes! And scientific concepts that many students find too abstract to grasp. You see what I'm saying? So see how that is a form of communication, even through education. And it can be fun. And I'm thinking that is a, you know, I saw on TV a little while ago, I was looking at this TV program with my grandchildren. And this young man got up and started to dance. He was just a dancer, was just having fun. But what happened was when he went out there and played sports, he made a touchdown quicker because he learned how to be able to leap and dance and use his body. So that's the way that we can actually teach them how to baby use their bodies, have fun, and make touchdowns, not only on the field, but in life.
Yes.
Touchdowns in life. I like that idea.
Make a touchdown in life.
It's kind of like leveling up in the game world, where you get better and better at doing your game of life, and each time you do, the game gets bigger, and you get smarter.
Is my mic on?
Your mic is on.
Your mic is on.
Hey, this all reminds me of something I learned as I got older, and that is peace is more fun.
It is.
Yes. That's the bottom line, yeah.
Wait a minute. Peace is more fun. Wait a minute. You haven't seen Madea's piece. You know what Madea
is. I know what Madea is.
Madea piece is what? A gun.
Oh, well, I don't mean that. That hurts. No. No, but peace, P-E-A-C-E.
Okay, not the peace.
Is more fun than violence.
It is.
When you're around violence, even the threat of violence, there's a tension in the air. If there's a threat of bullying or making fun of someone, there is a tension in the air. And we are not free then to be ourselves and to be our best. We're on alert. But an environment of peace is more fun. We're relaxed. We're creative. And that's why we need more peace and less of the tension.
Right. And we can do that by integrating dance as a part mm-hmm. of our daily life. I went last week? Yes, last week I went to see my granddaughter, and that's what she did, was ballet. And she had so much fun out there on the ballet, you know, just twisting and turning and just had a good time, you know what I'm saying? And all of that is a part of dancing. For instance, it said watching a ballet or performance-based ballet moves teaches children about shapes,
mm-hmm.
patterns,
mm-hmm.
angles, and rotational symmetries.
Rotational
symmetries.
Yeah.
Which is a part of math.
And yeah. all that time, they're improving their bodies.
Yes.
They're toning their muscles, their
yes.
balance.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. So this is a way we can be able to use that math as a part of the workshop in dance.
Right. You're going to yeah. have that the night of your fashion show?
I'm thinking about that. We could be talking about that fashion show. We're going to bring that up. How we could be able to use all of that as a part of our fashion show. And see, that's what the whole goal of the fashion show is to say, what it say, is being able to use fashion to change
mm-hmm.
lives.
Mm-hmm.
But fashion can be not only just clothes, but fashion can be the way you care yourself.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
Fashion can be, it make a statement.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
It's posture, it's that inner glow, it's lots of good things.
A lot of good things. So if we can get our students to come a part of doing something like that
mm-hmm.
instead of out on the street. And not only that, you will also find how they can be able to make money
mm-hmm.
doing fashion shows.
That's right.
Dancing and singing and all of those good things.
Right. One of the teenagers you had on last week
uh-huh.
already makes wardrobes for her dolls.
Yes.
And then she can take them apart and redo them. She's practicing all kinds of fashion and style
mm-hmm.
and so
mm-hmm.
forth.
Mm-hmm.
And then, yes, that can be a wonderful career for her.
Yes. Yes. And I'm going to share that with you as we move forward. Appreciating dance in society. Oh, let's go back. They also said that dance activities teach ideas as diverse as chemical bonding, mm-hmm, plate tectonics, and astronomy.
Mm-hmm. Really?
When I was teaching,
mm-hmm.
I remember one unit I did with fifth graders.
Mm-hmm.
We were studying the internal combustion engine.
Mm-hmm.
That was before electric cars and before a lot of other things.
Mm-hmm.
And as part of the unit, the kids had to be able to identify like 10 different things under the hood.
Mm-hmm.
And their fathers or mothers could come in and bring their car, and it would be out in the parking lot, and we'd
mm-hmm.
all swarm around it and name the 10 parts.
Mm-hmm.
But also then we came up with a little dance.
Mm-hmm. Really?
Well, you know how the spark plug sparks off and then the
mm-hmm.
cylinder, the action goes on the cylinder. So some of the kids would be up and some would be down
mm-hmm.
to show the
like
the different dynamics that goes on in an internal combustion engine.
Mm-hmm.
That was a cute dance.
Mm-hmm.
Really, acting out an engine.
Mm-hmm.
Uh-huh. That's cute.
Mm-hmm. And I was also thinking too how they get together. Like I said, even when you're racing, in the energy as it rolls up, what do they do? They have the cheerleaders out
mm-hmm.
dancing.
Mm-hmm.
You see what I'm saying? In
mm-hmm.
all sports, it's out there. All that is a part of dancing. So it's like pushing and applauding each other
mm-hmm.
on. And that's trigger something in your brain that up there caused healing
mm-hmm.
versus the negativity, which actually caused sickness.
Mm-hmm. It brings out the serotonin.
Yeah. So maybe we need to test. That's what we can use for this, this virus.
For the virus, yeah, just smile and dance. Dance it off. The coronavirus dance. The two-step or the three-step or whatever.
Yes.
And we have here our ready wipes.
Yes. See how we can include everything as a part of the healing, really.
Right.
Robin, if you're upbeat, you're going to heal faster, that's for sure.
Uh-huh.
Epigenetics talks about that.
So we see how we include in... So, the Canonis Fryers. Hey, y'all, we just need to throw one great big party.
But keep don't
everybody,
anybody.
Yeah, dance in your home in quarantine.
we could do that in quarantine and just have a ball.
You can still dance, right?
Yes, and you can still laugh, you can still have fun, right?
Right.
Yes.
It gets your blood flowing faster and you heal faster and you're having a good time. And we always heal faster when we're feeling good.
Okay.
Having fun.
That's it. That's the reason why we have fun here on.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Here, oh, that's right. That brings up to the hour for a commercial for the works. You're hearing all of this good, wonderful news on 93.9 FM here on
RWK.
LP.
All right.
FM.
The Work FM.
The Work FM. And if you'd like to call in, that number is 804-464-1089. Call us in. Call us. And share with us, what do you think about dancing? It said dancing your way through the tulips, dancing your way through life.
Through the virus, right.
Yeah, yes, through the virus. Dancing brings people together and preserves rich culture traditions. For instance, children attending a powwow gain an experience of other culture and see firsthand the role of dance in society. By including dance in childhood education, students discover that learning is fun, interactive, and interesting. Never dull, never bored. Do you know what I'm saying? We don't have dull and bored moments right here.
And if you go to a wedding reception or a bar mitzvah or a bat mitzvah reception, there's lots of dancing, and it's so cute to watch the cross-generational dancing. Older folks dancing with young folks, having fun, having a good time, no harm being done, just a good time.
And that's what gonna happen at our fashion show. We're leading up to that moment to
talk
about the fashion show. So we want individuals to call us and see how they can become a part of this fashion show.
That's right. Some of the listeners might have ideas about how to do a fashion show. They want to be part of it, or some dance they want to do for the fashion show, call in. What's the number, Liz?
The number is 804-464-1089. Call in and share what you think of, hey, coming a part of our campus.
Build a better society.
Yes, it is. And it's healthy.
One step at a time, and it could be a dance step.
We sure could. We could actually come up with a dance step for that. The chest, but it does sound like a little dance, doesn't it?
It does. that buzz on the end there, that's grooving.
We've been talking about how dancing has been is interactive and exciting. Dance also improves our physical and mental well-being. It also offers nutrition advice and diet plans.
Oh.
Yes. You have to be physically fit in order to dance.
You can start slow. In fact, you can start sitting down. I remember this. You can do chair dancing. Get you started with the rhythm. Get your feet moving. Then when you're ready and able, get up and...
start dancing.
Do the whole dance, right.
Do the whole dance. As a business, let me tell you what you can do as a business. Dancing
okay.
can be utilized and it complement the service of, let's say, wax and brow treatment. So it's a part of the beauty treatment.
Huh.
Uh-huh. Nail bar, get your nails done. See what dance is like the answer. Dance can also be used for recreation and entertainment.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. But that, like sports. And
you know, folk dancing is one of my favorite kinds of dance. When you do folk dancing,
mm-hmm.
you're dancing to the music of the people who originated that particular dance.
Mm-hmm.
For instance, music from Yugoslavia, which used to be one country,
mm-hmm.
that music is very neat and it's syncopated, mm-hmm. a very uneven beat.
Mm-hmm.
And their folk dances reflect that uneven beat. Mm-hmm. And they're fun to do.
Yes, yes. Guess what? I'm going to share with you the careers that you can attain through dancing. You can be a dance teacher.
Mm-hmm.
The way Coach Charmaine is.
And mm-hmm.
hopefully we will be hearing from her. They are practicing for an event that is happening out of the state. And they want to be able to participate in this parade. Mm-hmm. So they've been putting in hard hours
And this is the Blue Jewel dance team?
Yes. Yeah.
Okay, and they'll be at your fashion show too, right?
Fashion show. And guess what else they could be doing? Remember the young lady, Najal? She said that she do the drawing for the patent. She's the one to go come up with the patents.
Mm.
She could draw her own little patterns for design.
For dresses and outfits, dance outfits?
Yes.
Great.
Isn't that awesome?
That's creativity.
That is creativity. And of course, her sisters could be doing the art of making up.
The makeup.
Mm-hmm.
What about, will someone there be doing nails?
We're going to have to get someone to do the nails. Yes. So as you look at all of the careers mm-hmm. that is coming out of this one little fashion show that they are creating. And these girls are just 14 years old.
Mm-hmm.
Some of them are even younger. They have some of the little kids who's just 2 years old is out there dancing. I went today and I saw them and they was out there. Oh, they were just a kicking and just a moving.
You remember that song from Taj Mahal, Liz?
Uh-huh.
You remember the soulful tune? It's a soulful tune. You can sing in the key. Let your knees start to jump and get your heart start to pump. It's a soulful tune. Come on and sing me your tune.
That's it. Now say it in English.
Oh my gosh. That brings it up to the choreographics.
Choreography.
Say it again.
Choreography. There's no L in it.
Okay.
Choreography.
And the photographer and the video.
Yeah, the choreographer has to decide what steps they'll do in uh-huh. what sequence.
And then video it mm-hmm. and take pictures of it. And look, that's another money making because you sell that to them.
Mm-hmm.
To the individuals who up there is doing all this. So that's this whole package. Is full of
opportunities.
Opportunities. Mm-hmm. Uh-huh.
And all these make wonderful hobbies.
Yes.
When you're young, and they could make a career
when you're
later
older.
On. Yeah.
Like works in the art of an administration mm-hmm. for a dance company or theater.
Or making the costumes for the dance outfit.
Yeah, it's coming up on that.
Oh.
Or become a yoga.
A yoga?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
A yoga instructor to give yes. private lessons.
Healthy use of your body, how
yes.
to relieve strain in your muscles and joints. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And then there is the marketing. The marketing mm-hmm. for dancers that work in the field and designing and maintaining the websites
mm-hmm.
for the company that be able to.
Yeah, and advertising for the company.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Publicity.
So, mm-hmm. 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 And so all of this is a part of that one word, dance.
Mm-hmm.
And it's all, mm-hmm. it's nothing negative about dancing.
Right, there's no harm.
No harm at all. And then, of course, as you were saying earlier, the cartoons, the costumes,
mm-hmm.
the clothing, designing, and you can create your own costumes, your own little dance wear. You see,
mm-hmm.
you,
mm-hmm.
and all of that can, you can actually say, be able to design it for yourself. And with Facebook being the way it is, you can actually sell it on Facebook.
Mm-hmm.
Right. You see what I'm saying?
So, all kinds of possibilities.
All kinds of possibilities that can be integrated into this fashion show to be able to help teach our young people how they can stop the education pipeline to jail.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
There's no reason to go on that pipeline.
There's no reason at all. Mm-mm. This is the part that we will be starting hopefully this week. It's to teach them how to sew.
Sewing.
Sewing and create their own costumes. And this could leave in working in a costume department or either a dance company. You see,
great.
What I'm saying?
Ron and I were at a event a few weeks ago, and the young gal there had made the pair of blue jeans she was wearing.
Yes, right.
What?
They looked like store-bought.
Yeah, rivets.
She had done a beautiful job. She had a few extra little things here and there that she cared about that she sewed in. They fit her perfectly. She made her own pattern and sewed her own jeans.
She was a sewist. A self-declared sewist.
No, she's a seamstress.
Well, yeah, she called herself a sewist. I thought that was cuter.
And I asked her how she got into that. Was that something she learned at school? And she said she was lucky. She was in school in home ec where they taught sewing at a time when it had become a real rage. And so girls across the country, maybe around the world, were on Instagram.
Mm-hmm.
We're sharing ideas about sewing this and that and pattern this and that and little hints and tips. And so she said she was part of a large group of girls and guys, probably, who were into sewing. Now, isn't that a neat community to be part
that
of,
is,
too?
That
and
is.
That's another thing. When you're a dancer or costume maker or all these things, you've got a whole
artists.
Community of people on the internet who would share that with you.
Yes, yes, yes. So, and that also would put you into, say, dancing, also put you into the filmmaker. You see what I'm
saying? Videographer and
all of
director.
The, yes.
Yes.
All of the things that can come out that one little word, dancing. Healing.
Write the music.
The music.
And
that's that also include poetry.
And playing the music.
Playing.
Musicianship.
The other one is, of course, in a fashion show, you know you have to have your hair done.
Yes.
So there comes the cosmetology.
Right.
And the different hairstyles that you have to go with the cosmetology. You see what I'm saying? So that's the braids and the waves. And,
and the ponytails.
Yes. I mean, of all of the, it's just so much that can be able to be stimulating and stopping the pipeline to jail. And these are things that our young people can do. These are the things that we need to be able to say, get the schools involved, the churches involved. And the university is involved. So that's the reason why we have to really just say, pray that coronavirus, the virus, we don't have time for that. So this is what I'm thinking, that they can be able to call us and we can give them a conference and we can have a conference call so that we can be able to involve them whilst the school is closed.
Yeah, that's right.
All the schools are closed. This is the way we can get this started.
Right.
Don't you think that's a great idea?
I think that's a wonderful idea.
Yeah, so we're going to have to come up with a conference number.
Mm-hmm.
And in the meantime, you can call me at 571-314-7503. And I can be able to give you a conference number so that you can call in and find out how we can be able to strategize for this fashion show.
And that invitation is for guys and gals.
Yes.
A lot of guys, I know football players, professional football players even, take ballet classes.
Yes.
To learn to use their bodies better.
Yes.
So this is definitely for guys as well.
Yes, definitely for guys as well.
Get that energy out in a useful, beautiful way. Dance it out.
Yes, yes. Instead of going and shooting it up.
Shooting it out.
Yeah. Shooting it up. That's an easy, lazy way to get rid of your frustration. And you don't need to, and not only that, you lose your life. You lose your loved ones. And so what we're saying is use an alternative.
Yeah.
Really, violence isn't even an alternative. It's just frustration. It's like screaming or kicking the dog or punching a hole in the wall. It's totally meaningless, but it is an expression of frustration. And mm-hmm. and there it is, a genuine expression of frustration.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Another one is becoming a physical therapist or dance medicine specialist.
Sure.
You see what I'm saying? Again, yeah. It's a cure mm-hmm. instead of a defeated purpose.
It's a healing process,
It's a healing process. Mm-hmm. And that's what our community needs. Our community needs that healing process. It needs to, and you can be a part of it. And it doesn't cost that much. All it costs is a little bit of time, a little bit of interest, and a little bit of love, mm-hmm. which is most important. Mm-hmm. You don't have a whole lot of love, but if you had just one little piece, it would drop like a, you know how a faucet from the water,
mm-hmm.
drop from the faucet, it goes click, click. And if you keep it there long enough, from that one little drop over time period, you have a whole glass of water.
That's right.
Just from little drops. So that's what we're asking for, just little drops to be able to come in and help heal the community and stop the violence and be able to change the maybe you can't change the world, but you can change your friend.
You can change yourself.
You can change yourself. Mm-hmm. And that medicine specialist, it gives, because you are a dancer, you have the ability to relate to another dancer and understand the dancer's body. You know what to massage, you know what it need to, because you have already experienced it. And in that way, it give you an advantage.
Right.
Over a regular doctor. You see mm-hmm. what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
Or a regular therapist, because you have already went through, you probably done already had some of the aches and pains yourself as a dancer, mm-hmm. because a dancer don't come overnight after.
That's right. Good dancing takes practice.
Like everything else, mm-hmm. right? Again, you're listening to 93.9 FM, The Work Radio. And remember, you heard it first right here on The Work. And what are those call numbers?
WRWK.
All right, The Work, 93.9 FM.
And we serve Chesterfield, Enrico, Richmond, Goochland, and Hanover. And you can see us on Facebook. You can see us on YouTube. You can hear us over the radio if you live within 10 miles of Midlothian.
Yep.
I listen to it on my phone.
Do you?
Yeah, I just go to the Work FM.
Mm-hmm.
Push the button for live listen to, and of course, you got to have it plugged in, because you'll get so engrossed in the programs
mm-hmm.
that you'll forget you're using your battery.
That's right.
And your battery, you will find your battery dead, huh?
So, Liz, when are you going to tell us about the fashion show?
Well, let me do that now. This is what is going on with the fashion show. Youth Corporation Inc. is partnering with community organizations like the
WRWK.
Yes. And we're partnering with corporations, churches, and universities, and even politicians. I'll give you a few politicians that I want to come and speak on it. What we want to do is the theme is Given a New Life with Fashion. And the fashion show, it will be a luncheon too. It's going to be held at the Four Point by Sheraton Hotel at 4700 South Laburnum Avenue in Richmond, Virginia. And it is a benefit to help the homeless population and to stop the education pipeline to jail. The purpose is to provide housing, jobs, and mental health care, and to clean up Tent City.
Ah, right.
You know they have a deadline. They have to get that. They have to get that.
No. When is that?
They had said March the 31st, but I think they're working on it to push it up further.
What are they doing about the coronavirus?
I talked to Rhonda yesterday, and she said that she likes to spend the night out there just to keep check on them. You know? She is doing a whole lot. They have another lady, too, who have come on the scene. And haven't talked to her yet. But we're going to see how we can be able to pull the two of them together.
What does the city think will happen after the end of March for all these folks who live in these tents?
That's the reason why we got to get out there and work and try to get them out of the tents. And so we're doing some strategy right now. I don't want to put it out on the air right now.
Okay.
But we're strategizing some
behind things. The scenes. Okay.
We're behind the scenes right now.
Meanwhile, they could probably use donations of food and maybe sleeping bags and tents.
Yes. Yes. And then
dry socks.
Yes. And special Medicare. You know they'll open up the building there.
Oh, good.
Conrad Center.
On Wednesdays they're supposed to be having. The only thing is, I had a friend to go there, and he was saying that nobody is going into the building because they are out in the streets trying to find, you know, what they need. Mm-hmm. Where they have the building right there, and so some kind of way they got to connect it to.
Mm-hmm. Yep, they sure do, and they need cots. What I heard a few weeks ago. They had a little thin foam mattress on the cement floor, and that was your bed. They had no cots.
They were basically gym mats.
For tumbling and exercising.
That sort of thing.
They weren't real mattresses. So they need cots, they need more thicker mattresses, and then they've probably got it organized, a room for men, a room for women. But I know they don't allow smoking in the building.
Mm-hmm.
And that's a very reasonable rule, I think.
Yeah, it is. Mm-hmm. It is. Smoke is not healthy.
Right. And then everyone else has to be part of your smoke.
Mm-hmm. Secondhand smoke is not good. Mm-hmm. It's as bad as you smoking yourself.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. My sister lived with my stepfather. And she got some of the symptoms that he had. She doesn't smoke, and he did. And it's not good for the health at all, you know. Not only that, get bad breath.
There's that too, and your clothes smell.
It does. Mm-hmm. And I have a way of going, and I can almost like just smell that that smoke, and it can be very frustrating.
And now with this coronavirus, which seems to be worse in the lungs than anywhere else, people who smoke need to stop immediately because they'll need the healthiest lungs they can have.
Yes. So this fashion show, our goal is to start that where we can stop or reduce recidivism and build what we say a healthy community, and better societies.
Right on.
And that's where we want to pull everybody together to help us to do that. We don't want any division in there. We want to be able to have everybody that can be able to help to help.
That's right.
So how can we do that? The highlight of the fashion show is where students, of course, are designing and sewing their own outfits for the sewing classes that is taken from the Church Buzz facility. That is Community Health and United, Building Better Societies. And the theme is Special Design by You. Okay? The other categories are as following. We're looking for little kids, 2 to 12 years old, and they will say, be yourself wear. So what we're looking for is some stores who will allow us to use some of their outfits for the 2 to 12 years old.
And they'll model them in the fashion show.
Yes. And that would like, this is sponsored to you by, of course, mm-hmm. whatever store mm-hmm. that we can up and get to do that. So that would bring special attention to their store, of course.
Mm-hmm.
And then, of course, there is also the teens, and they're from 13 to 17, and that is school wear and prom night.
Mm-hmm.
So there'll be school and, you know, as you say, formal wear.
Mm-hmm.
And so there'll be, so and you know we're going to need music for each one of these mm-hmm. categories, mm-hmm. right? The next one is the young adults, and that is from 18 to 30. And that is, of course, the office place and the after-hours wear.
Ah, the lounge wear.
Huh?
Yeah. What you wear when you're lounging at home?
No. I was thinking more like after hours, like at the bar.
Oh, going out for dinner and cocktails.
Yeah,
okay.
Yes. And then there is the adults, and that is 31 and up. And we want to do it on May the 9th, and that give us a little time to get it all together. And that would be, we say, a special for Mother's Day tribute.
Why not?
Yes. And, of course, we're going to have what you call the oldies but goodies.
Yeah.
And the church wear.
Church wear, yes. And hats.
Yeah.
That includes hats.
Yeah. You know how they like to wear those hats.
Mm-hmm. Uh-huh. Big hats.
So, again, give me a call at 571-314-7503 if you like to become a part of this fashion show and help us create the moment.
Yes.
That is specially for you. Okay.
The first annual fashion show.
Yes.
So what time? There's a luncheon
with
this?
There's a luncheon. Mm-hmm. And the time we're looking at is from... we say from 12 to 6.
12 to 6. Now,
there's other things that will be going on.
Because
mm-hmm. what we will have there is, of course, we can have the music, the dance, and the vendors in the following areas.
Mm-hmm.
That is, of course, the jewelry.
Mm-hmm.
No fashion show is complete without the jewelry.
That's right, those accessories.
And then the makeup artist.
Mm-hmm.
And then, of course, we will have seminars because what we want to do is actually those individuals at Tent City,
mm-hmm.
we want to actually go and get them and bring them there so mm-hmm. they can be able to sign up for the finances. We'll have individuals do financial seminars.
Mm.
Housing seminars, and of course, construction seminars. And we have, you know, get those individuals. And then, of course, we have the special speakers in the area of criminal justice, juvenile social justice, probation, and community policing.
Wow, you've got everything there.
Everything will be right there under one roof. And this is where we're bringing the rich and the poor together,
mm-hmm.
the young and the old together. We
mm-hmm.
want to bring it together as a unity
mm-hmm.
to be able to get people to come out. And we want to be able to solve these social issues that
mm-hmm.
are right here in our city and surrounding counties.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Again, if you're interested, give us a call. You can call us while we are here on the air. Tell us what you think. And that is, of course, that number here is 804-464-1089. So give us a call while we're here on air. And my number, you can meet, call me at 571-314-7503. Guess what else we're going to have?
I can't guess.
Authors, local authors, that can be able to come and do that book signing.
Because you had an author, well, her family was here last week. And then Fred's an author, too.
Yes, Fred, author. And then remember Amy, who was on here? We have a lot of, we have met so
and
many.
And you're an author.
And I'm an author, yes.
Yeah.
Yeah. We have met so many people here by having this radio show. And all of the people that we have been talking with, this is sort of like our climax. Those are the ones that we can be able to come and help us put the fashion show on.
And you're going to have student reporters there who will be able to talk about
what's
the next week on your show.
Yes, yes. Isn't that awesome?
It is.
Uh-huh. And then, of course, we have local churches. We want to invite local churches. I want to say all churches are invited. I'm not going to say it got to be Baptist, it got to be Methodist, it got to be Presbyterian. Anybody, any church that want to come and become a part of this, just to let people know you're out there and you want to do something about the homeless and stop the pipeline to jail, give us a call. Again, that number is...
At the station or at your house?
At the station.
The number at the station, 804-464-1089.
All right. I want to thank the work, 93.9. I really want to thank the work for the hard work that they are doing to bring stability into the community, to bring the community into, let's say, a way to reach out to people there. And, well, of course, we want the work to be there. You know that, right? Ron, you know, we want the work to be there. We want 93.9 to be there.
That's right, and vice versa.
Remote broadcasting from...
Yeah. Yes, yeah, from the hotel, Four Point Hotel by Sheraton, right there at the 4700 South Laburnum Avenue. Of course, as we move forward, we will be sharing how much the tickets would be for the show, for the whole event. That's our way of being able to get the people involved. How much it would be for the whole
event.
Event. So we do have local. So we do. We need your help. If you want to be a part of this, a part of the community, a part of making our community a better place, a better society, we just ask you to come and help us. Well, you know, we have come a long way since we first met Ron.
Yep.
In last year when we first, it'd been exactly a year.
Has it? I didn't realize that.
No, it would be a year in April. It'd be a year in April. We have did a lot of activities. We have we have did a long ways. What we have, you know. So we are moving forward, and we're just happy about the relationship that we have put together right here with the radio station, the community, and with the Chat Buzz.
That's synergy. Synergy. Everybody's working together, so helping each other succeed.
Yes, and as you would say, it's a good connected energy.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? It's good energy. It's not where we are bashing each other heads or trying, you know, trying to compete against each other. Mm-hmm. We are working together, mm-hmm. and that makes all the difference in the world. And it's by the Spirit. You know what I'm saying? It's that Spirit part. It's not like we're trying to overpower or get mightier, but it's mm-hmm. that Spirit part that is definitely drawing us together.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. We're not drawn here, dragging. We're not dragged here, screaming and putting on a fit. We walked here willingly.
Yes. That's right.
Yes. And that's what we need. That's what we need. We need people coming together, not as a big I, little you, mm-hmm. but as connecting.
Equal.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And that's what is so important. And, you know, that's what I have really experienced with you and Ron. That's what I have really experienced with you. And I really want to give a shout out to my, like Clyde. Clyde has mm-hmm. been working with, and he's been out there videotaping everything, and that's a good thing as well. And as you said, Lo came in, mm-hmm. and he's looking
He wants to be part of it, yeah.
Yeah, so our little connection is really growing.
Yeah, all the young people you've brought, and mm-hmm. they'll probably all want to be involved mm-hmm. in the big celebration in May.
Yes. That's a good way to kick it all off, huh? Mm-hmm. Yes, it is. And because we have to deal with the middle school, the high school, and the college students now that is coming aboard. It's just like they get a taste of it and go, wow, this is good.
And keeping them all busy if they don't have school.
Uh-huh. Yes.
Now, spring break starts for most of them next week anyway, right?
Yes, yes.
And then the schools will be closed a while after that, or do you know?
I think so. I really, you know what, I'm not even sure. But I want to keep them busy. Mm-hmm. And that's the reason why we're going to have like little conference calls.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, because we had, what's it? We had the other young lady, Tatiana. Yeah, Tatiana mm-hmm. last week. She said, oh, she let me know that she's out of reset.
Good, she's all reset. Good. It's like pushing the refresh button, right?
And she said, whilst we're out, Miss Liz, we'll be giving you a call on the, said the telephone. We're going to have a telephone conference call.
Because she needs to be in on the May 9th celebration, too.
Yes, she does. Hey, you know what? Lo does DJ. So we probably get him the DJ part of this.
Yes.
Oh, my gosh. Isn't that awesome? So see how we're bringing in all of that mm-hmm. talents, their little gifts mm-hmm. into the one big show.
Mm-hmm. Yep. They'll invest their talents, mm-hmm. their time, and their mm-hmm. energy.
Mm-hmm.
Help it make it a big success.
They will. And they have been so faithful in the past in helping to put in helping to just bring it to where it is now. You know what I'm saying? Because we start off with just an idea.
Mm-hmm.
It was just a thought.
Mm-hmm.
And we have came a long ways.
Yeah.
Yes, we have. Oh, but we're waiting. We're looking for to hear from the coach, the dance coach,
she'll be calling you today?
Yeah, she's supposed to be calling me, Coach Shimon. She's the one who's working with the young ladies.
Mm-hmm. The dance coach?
Yes, the dance coach. And like I said, their ages are from 2 to 14 years old.
And they're getting ready for a big competition, is that right?
They're getting ready for a big competition. Mm-hmm. Yes. They could be in a parade, and they are all excited. But they've been practicing today from 12 until 5. So they just finished practicing. So hopefully we should be hearing from them to call in and share about the dance group.
I saw a picture of their bright, sparkly blue dance outfits. Very pretty.
Yes, 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 they are.
So while you wait for them to call, you were saying something about kids learning to sew?
Yes, yes. I don't know if you have met Miss Doris James, but Miss Doris James is the one who, yes, you have met Miss Doris James. She was at the...
Open House?
The Open House, yes. She's the one for the Ladies of Justice. And she also was the one that would be doing the sewing. She would be teaching them how to sew. She's a seamstress.
Wonderful.
Yes.
That's a marvelous skill to have.
It is. So she is going to be teaching them how to sew their outfits. Yes. So as you can see, we have a lot going on here. And this would keep them busy whilst they're out of school.
That's right. Maybe she could be on the air telling people some basics about
sewing.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to see if I can get her. She has a very busy, busy schedule. She really does.
When I lived in the Middle East way long time ago, there were seamstresses because there weren't any ready-made clothes for sale. There weren't mm-hmm. any department stores mm-hmm. at that time. So everything you had to buy the material and hire a seamstress. And
mm-hmm.
So the seamstresses used what they called the European method,
mm-hmm.
which is you meet your client,
mm-hmm.
you make a pattern to fit them.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Made out of muslin, some mm-hmm. kind of inexpensive mm-hmm. material.
Mm-hmm.
So you have this basic pattern.
Mm-hmm.
So then the client can come in anytime and say, I have this blue material. I'd like a dress made out of it
mm-hmm.
with a V-neck or whatever. They'd say, okay, fine, just leave it here. I'll call you in for a fitting later. Because they already had this pattern made for your size, your
mm-hmm.
shape.
Mm-hmm.
And that's how they were doing it in Europe at the time.
Mm-hmm.
And that was very different from the American way. It's where you buy a paper pattern,
mm-hmm.
a size that you think might fit you,
mm-hmm.
and it might not. And then you put that little thin paper pattern, you pin it to the material, and then you cut it out and sew it. And you can tell maybe that I never succeeded really well in this field, but... Those are the differences I saw in the American way and the European way.
Well, let me tell you, my sister used to sew all our little costumes, our little outfits, when we used to do the Christmas play at church.
Mm-hmm.
She used to buy her own little, she used to get the little, instead of buying the pattern, we didn't have the money to buy the pattern. So what we did was just went and got newspaper.
Mm-hmm.
On some paper and just drawed her out. And
mm-hmm.
she used to make the cutest little outfits. She really did.
That's a good way to do it.
Uh-huh. Yes. Yes. In fact, I got to get in contact with her, see if she got a sewing machine I can use.
Yeah.
Because she could be one of those old ones that...
The treadle?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. The antique.
I have my grandma's old treadle sewing machine. Someday I'm going to use it.
Where is it, at home?
Yeah, it's at my house in Michigan.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Yes. But she did. I used to write the plays.
Ah.
And she used to do the costumes.
What a group. What a pair.
Yeah. So that's what, you know, and it brings back a lot of memories. So that can be, that's almost like the costumes and the fashion show. You see what I'm saying?
It sure is. And, you know... my boyfriend, who passed away 2 years ago, he had a sewing machine and he loved to sew.
Mm-hmm.
Here's what he liked to make. He liked to make sleeping bags, and he was a sailor. He had a sailboat,
uh-huh.
and he liked to make the sails.
Uh-huh.
He would make different colors of canvas depending on what flag he wanted to fly
uh-huh.
that summer.
Uh-huh.
And he loved to sew, and he loved to mend.
Right.
He had a machine that would sew really heavy things like leather and
mm-hmm.
denim
mm-hmm.
and canvas. And, mm-hmm. yeah, a lot of guys like to sew.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So this is a field for guys and gals.
It is. It's a field. And because it's become a fashion designer.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. So that's what we want to really do is teach them the fashion designer where they can be able to learn how to be able to, say, draw the pattern, design it, and even put them up, you know.
Wear them.
Mm-hmm. And sell them.
Mm-hmm.
And look at all the jobs that it would create.
Right on.
Mm-hmm. So that's our goal. We are teaching our young people how to be entrepreneurs.
That's right. Work for yourself.
That's it. And see how that would bring up the economy?
We have a show here on Thursdays of Richmond Business Babes, it's called. And and the host there, she has different folks contact her, different women who own their own business in the Richmond area. They come on and talk about what was the toughest part, what did you have to do to get ready for it, what were you surprised to find out, and so on. So when these kids become successes or on their way to success, they can come and be on a show at our station, WRWK.
That's it, right here on, I like to say it, 93.9 FM, The Works. Because we work the plane and the plane work for us.
That's right.
Yes.
It gives back.
Yes. Mm-hmm. I want to send out a special thank you to William H. Lightfoot, and he's with Lightfoot Consulting Association. He is the one that actually gave me all the information on the domestic violence. He's also a part of the legislature and the government affairs at the General Assembly. He works mostly with elder abuse and domestic violence. And you, if you like to get in contact with him, his number is 804-986-4631. He does a lot of work for people our age. Yes. He said a lot of them are being scammed or abused. And a lot of them, you know, have children that don't come to see them. And he is always, and he said that group is the worst group as far as the General Assembly is concerned. They don't seem to be concerned about the elderly in the General Assembly as far as getting laws passed for them. So that's his specialty.
Wonderful.
We've been under that ourselves when our mom was old. Since the agencies that were supposed to be taking care of elderly and elder abuse were sort of toothless.
Yeah, they really did nothing to be helpful.
Just a name only?
Yeah, they might have come once or twice. And well, our mom was kind of a feisty gal, and she was very independent.
Yeah, she didn't want to.
And she didn't feel she needed any kind of help. So when these people would come to the door to offer her their services, well, we don't need any such thing. I don't know who called you. We don't need that. And so she kept away some of the health that might have been there. But they could have been a little better at manipulating her, I think, and
appreciating her position. Yeah.
Yeah.
She didn't want to be pampered or catered to.
Uh-huh.
She had her pride, and I think that's something that we found that they sort of thought that the elder would be kind of mindless or just be like babies. Mm-hmm. Want to be watch movies all day and sit down and play games. Mom was none of that mind.
Mm-hmm.
Now, if they'd had a good book club or discussed the books they'd read or something, she'd have been interested in that.
Right.
Yeah.
But there was nothing like that available.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, she wasn't a consumer in that sense. She was looking for something to do with her mind. Mm. She had things. She loved to read. Mm-hmm. And the only thing she watched the TV such news was Lawrence Welk.
Mm-hmm.
Well, no, she also CBS. Watched, what's his name, at Mayberry.
Oh, yeah. She did love, what's his name? Mm-hmm.
Andy Griffith.
Andy Griffith, yes.
Oh, she liked Andy Griffith. Yeah.
That was a good old days. Yeah, she grew up in that.
Yeah, I remember when my sister was born. Remember Thelma on Andy Griffin?
Who's that?
Thelma.
Thelma. Does ring a bell.
Uh-huh. She was on the Andy Griffin show. I named my sister.
You named her Thelma based on that? Well, that wasn't a bad idea. That worked.
I'm not so sure my sister liked that. But
later, we get to choose our own names, don't we?
Yes.
Yeah.
It was that I call it Thelma Lou, but really, I don't know if she's listening, but anyway.
That was a fun show.
It was
innocent. Everything turned out, by the end of the hour, everything was fine again.
Mm-hmm. Half hour, wasn't it?
Mm-hmm.
Half hour?
Was it half hour?
It was a half an hour, I think it was.
It was pretty brief, and they touched on some interesting topics.
We haven't talked about St. Patrick's Day yet.
No, I haven't. You're talking about my hat, right?
What is the purpose of St. Patrick's Day?
Yeah, Ron.
Well, St. Patrick has quite a story. In fact, I happened to have it read to me last Thursday on the Rich and Business Babe show. Apparently, St. Patrick was actually a kid from Italy, of all places, mm-hmm. who was... things were pretty rough in the 4th century A.D. He was kidnapped.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know exactly where he was kidnapped from, but he was kidnapped and taken to Ireland
mm-hmm.
and as a kid. And eventually he managed to escape, made his way back to Italy, became a priest.
Mm-hmm.
And then he saw a vision saying, the folks up there in Ireland really need you.
Mm-hmm.
So he went back to Ireland, and he turned them all into Catholics.
Mm-hmm.
And he saved them from the snakes. There's a legend about...
Well, there's a lot of legends about him, yeah. I'm trying to stick to the few facts that I know. But so in the 4th century, he went back to Ireland, converted them all. And if you can imagine what it would have been like in the 4th century, pretty much it was right equals might equals right. Mm-hmm. Kind of like it is now. Oops, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to say that. Editorial slip. No, he probably brought a lot of very good ideas to a society that was probably... pretty rough and tumbled and didn't have a lot of philosophers in his past to draw on. So he probably brought a lot of stability and civilization, such mm-hmm. as it was in the 4th century A.D.,
mm-hmm.
to Ireland. So he was greatly admired for that.
Mm-hmm.
And I can't tell you why we pick him as our excuse to drink green beer and be rowdy.
Mm.
Mom loved those celebrations. We would take her to St. Patty's Day. Isn't that what they had in Churchill? And she yeah. loved that. And she would take her shillelagh, and she would wallop. She always seemed to have a shillelagh in her head, if not in her hand.
She loved bantering with the kids there, and they'd...
Yeah.
They'd threaten to tap her with the shillelagh, and she'd banter mm-hmm. back. And
oh, yeah.
She just loved it. All the commotion, all the dancing, all the music. She loved it.
Yeah.
And mm-hmm. Are they going to have to postpone that this year? What's happening this year?
I would guess so. Can you imagine in 2 days, they're not going to call off this national emergency so they can have a celebration? Maybe they should.
I really don't know the status of that, but it was a lot of fun, and I hope mm-hmm. they do, whenever they can, have those kind of fun activities again.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, well, we definitely need to keep ourselves upbeat and whatnot. You don't heal when you're downtrodden and feeling badly.
Right.
But that's because we'll have to look at the positive side of this debacle that our lack of preparedness and our focus on profits over progress has led us into. But the fact that the joyous time it'll be after we cure all of our stupidity and we get to the other side of this incident and we start doing things rationally for humans,
mm-hmm.
not to acquire toys or despoil the environment, but actually to do creative things,
mm-hmm.
that'll be a wonderful day.
Mm-hmm.
And I guess if it takes this to wake people up, hey, I'm all for it.
Well, we do have to realize that God do give us a choice.
That's right.
And when we take our own choice, it always leads to destruction.
Well, I wouldn't say, I would think you could say that we let the stupidest possible people be in charge of the most powerful things on the planet. We didn't have to do that. God didn't say, be stupid and I'll come fix you. In fact, God said, you have free dominion. Will.
Free will.
You can follow the Beatitudes and you can make it work, or you can be a total idiot, turn power over to the stupidest people, the most selfish people you'll find. And that's roughly what we've done.
So,
not to get into politics. That's another subject. Don't ask me about politics.
That is
I'm not getting into politics. I'm getting into we as individuals.
Yeah. Yes. What can we do here and now?
Yep. Yes.
Yeah.
Exactly.
But we, because one person can make a difference. They really can. So.
Mm-hmm. That's right.
You know, it started like a snowball. A little snow, little tiny snowball, and when people see your goodness and your light, that's the one that shine through the darkness. And you don't know what your one light would do in the midst of all this darkness that is going on.
That's right.
Like one word that you might say that would encourage or keep somebody from, you know, getting further down in the darkness. So in spite of what's going on, that's the reason why we was sharing about the dance, how it brings the joy, which I'm still waiting for you to give me a call, Shammer. Coach Shammer.
Oh, there you go. I'll watch for that phone.
Yeah, Shammer, I'm still waiting for you to give me a call.
And, hint, hint.
Here at the FM, 93.9 FM, The Works.
The Work FM, yes, 93.9. And we are licensed in Midlothian, but we also serve Chesterfield, Henrico, Richmond, Goochland, Hanover, and the entire internet universe. So call in 464-1089 and tell us what you'd like to add to the improvement of the world that we are discussing today. A team. It takes a large team.
It took a team for all of us working together to change society. That's the reason why we say we want to build better societies.
You know, I heard somewhere years ago that if 3% of the community has a very strong positive flow, it can change the community. That's 3% of the whole community. So when you have the efforts you're putting out here in the positive direction, moving people in a positive direction, bringing young people and middle-aged and older people along, that's having an effect to change the whole larger community.
Right.
A contagion of sanity.
Is it contagious? Yes.
Liz, here's my new business card.
What does it say? Oh, I like that. Make America good. Make America good. And each person, in the midst of all this darkness, if we have our little flashlight, and each one of us shine our little flashlight, guess what? We have a flood coming from all over the
that's
world.
That's right.
So that's the whole reason that we were making America good. It's because we started off with a little bit, but
we were given a lot of light, but we just tend to. The dark seems to be exciting, and people move into the dark to get excitement, but it usually betrays them. They fall into holes.
Dude, you?
Or get stuck.
Think so?
Well, that's my premise. When you look at the miracles in the Bible, I think, in large part, they were based on making people powerfully connected socially so they could trust each other, wherein they could begin to do good things.
Yeah.
It wasn't about one strong man coming in and telling him what to do. It was about him saying, hey, try this, you guys.
And gals.
I like that one, but he took the little boy and the fish. Was it 2 loaves of bread and 5 fish? Or was it just the opposite, 5 loaves of bread and 2 fish?
No, I think it was 2 loaves and
bread
5 fish.
And 5 fish. Mm-hmm. Well, and this is what we're doing with these young people that we have here. We were taking that little bit, that little talent. You know, they don't have very much, you know, except for, you know, they don't have much money. They don't have, you know, they don't have a say-so unless the parents say, yes, you can do it. You see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
But he happened to be there at the right time, and they went and asked. In fact, what did the disciples say to Jesus? Hey, these people are hungry. And he said, well, the disciples said, send them off. Let them go get that food.
We'll meet again at 2 o'clock. Yeah.
Meeting adjourned, yeah.
Let us adjourn and send them off to get that food. And Jesus said, no, we can't do it. And that's when he formed his miracle. He said, what do we have here? And we had a little boy that was willing to give what he had, give up, and it fed.
You know, part of that miracle is that in the Middle East, people traveled, they carried their lunch with them. And so, but they didn't want to eat in front of other people. So when one person got it out, got their food out, then the others felt comfortable getting theirs out. And so there was enough for everyone, including the fish and the bread that the young boy had. There was enough for everyone.
When they shared.
When they shared.
And there was more than enough, actually. Yeah. That was the end of the story. That's more than enough.
They collected what was extra.
What was left, though.
And that's the lesson. The lesson isn't that somebody pulled these out of their hat. The lesson was, trust will get us where we need to go, but positivity and trust and an appreciation for the lessons we were left with. The Beatitudes tell us what we should be doing. And we shouldn't wait for some odd miracle to pop out of the rock. The miracle is right here. Every single person is that miracle.
And we need to be prepared. One of my favorite sayings is in a meditation book that I read every morning, and that's God promises to feed the little birds, but he doesn't bring it to their nest.
No, they have to
go out and get it. Right. That's with us, too.
That's it.
It's not going to come land in our laps.
We have to run out and get it or come up with creative ideas.
Yeah, there's some work.
Help each other get it.
Huh?
Or help each other get it.
Help each other to get it. Yeah, it's called witty ideas. God give you witty ideas to be able to help others. To help yourself and to help others. He said he will bless the labor of your hand. He didn't say he will bless you with your hand.
Do it for you.
Here's a fancy yacht for you.
That's what he said. He will bless the labor of your hand.
You know, sometimes I pray for the billionaires that they will see the needs around them and start to help fill those needs. If every billionaire took on one of our states, for example, they could redo the infrastructure so that we had mass transit for people who needed it. So we had sewers and sanitation. We had good housing for low-income folks. A billionaire, one for each state, could redo everything that we need. And they'd still have enough left for their yacht. So
how about that?
Yeah.
That's a good point. Is what you do for others is what matters. It's not so much as what you're doing for yourself. But you will have to make sure that you know how to take care of yourself in order to be able to, what is it say? You have to love yourself in order to love others.
That is true. Yeah.
So you do have, but it's not saying you have to be greedy and grudging.
Right.
And it's just about myself. So it's about others.
And that old golden rule, do unto others as you would have them do to you. Or as I've heard from a slightly different slant, don't do to anyone what you don't want them to do to you.
Right. All right. I wonder, is there anyone out there listening to this? What's it? Building better societies. Building better societies. Would you like to become a part of the fashion show? Give us a call. And that number is, of course, we're looking for little kids. And that is from to be in the fashion show, and that is Be Yourself Wear. We're looking for teenagers, and that's school wear and prom night. We're looking for young adults, and that is the what you wear out into the office or the after hours wear.
Mm-hmm.
And then, of course, we're looking for the adults, and that is a special Mother's Day tribute. The oldies but goodies, and then, of course, the church wear. And each theme, of course, each theme will have a song or music behind it. Of course, the teens I know would be hip hop. The little kids, they're probably hip hop too. But the office wear and the after hours wear could be more soft. It could be jazz, you know.
Mm-hmm.
So if
mm-hmm.
there's anybody out there that up and want to do jazz music for us, that would be great. Give us a call. And then, of course, there is the adults and the oldies but goodies. That's more like the R&B and the church wears the gospel music.
mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. And then, of course, we have what you call any individuals out there who want to, say, set up that jewelry there that they can be able to use that, makeup artists, and, of course, looking for individuals. I have some basic people who have already signed up and said that they want to do this, but we're putting it out there in the public mm-hmm. because we want to get the community involved. We want mm-hmm. the whole community to be involved with what we're doing. All right. And we've given them enough time because this is just March. This is not happening until the second week in May.
Mm-hmm.
And it's right there on Mother's Day, too. So that would be a good Mother's Day event.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe things would be normal by then.
Oh, yeah. That I was thinking about that, too, Ron. Mm-hmm. Yeah, things would be normal by then. And, of course, we are bringing in politicians for the criminal justice, this juvenile social justice, the probation, and community policing.
Do they know they'll be required to dance? I hope so.
Oh, we probably have to get them to do the yes. Yes, we're going to have to get them to dance.
At least the bunny hop or whatever they're doing at the conga line.
Oh, how about that? Then we have the local authors and doing book signings. And then we have the local churches sharing their literature about their church. So you could get your church to come. Who is your church? What church you go to?
I have a few. Of course, there's Unity of Bon Air.
Mm-hmm.
They're active in a lot of community things.
So we can see if we can get them involved.
They need to know. Mm-hmm.
Uh-huh. So I could have you to get in contact with those mm-hmm. individuals, okay? Mm-hmm. So you can get in contact with the Unity Church. And what other, and who else?
And then there's a Baptist church near where we live in West End.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
The Refrain's Church, of course, has a thrift store. If you get a mix of fashions
we can get
Quakers.
It from there.
Quakers.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. In fact, I was thinking that we might can maybe use the thrift.
Yes.
Maybe get that.
The and wardrobe.
Yes. So
and Diversity Thrift.
Yes. So you're going to have to give me all the names of these individuals. So this is, oh my gosh, this is awesome.
And you know, it's fun. I know when I was teaching, we would have a little contest, sometimes the teachers would,
uh-huh.
about who could have the nicest outfit that cost the least money.
That
well,
would be nice.
We would shop at thrift stores.
That would be good.
And yeah, it uses your imagination
it
and
does.
Creativity.
You know, mm-hmm. I did a fashion show when I was up in Northern Virginia, and that's where the students went and bought their little older outfits too. And that's what they did. They did their little fashion show. They wouldn't pick out the outfits they wanted to do. And they did it themselves, you know? They had gotten the money to even so they were able to keep their little outfits.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Uh-huh.
And if, of course, any retail stores that want to loan us or donate us some wardrobes for this event, that would be okay,
that
too.
That would be good, too. So if you're listening, hey, we're looking for those individuals. So we want to make this a community effort where we will have the communities coming together from the north, east, south, and west.
And everywhere in between.
And everywhere between. We want to pull down barriers.
That's right.
Our goal, is to pull down barriers. We want to be able to pull down the barriers as far as the socialism. You know what I'm saying? Pull down those social barriers.
Yeah, social class barriers. And I want to mention something that one of our hosts here at the station, Stephanie, is very interested in doing in April, a cleanup, fix up, paint up campaign like they used to do in the past, where you focus on cleaning up the vacant lots, cleaning up your own yard, of course, and helping with the highways and so forth, so that everything looks nice and clean, our spring cleaning.
That's a good idea.
And then by Earth Day, we'll have it all ready.
Now, when is Earth Day?
Is it the 22nd of April?
I don't know. I'll look it up.
Okay. What is this about love, mercy, us?
Love, mercies.
Yeah, love, mercies.
Well, we're non-commercial, so we don't have commercials for when we get a commission. We have love commercials. We do things for love.
Okay.
They're intrinsically like, worth doing, so we do them because we care. So love commercials are just whatever people think. Gets them up in the morning, makes life worthwhile, makes life fun. They might be at a particular place they really like, they really depend on, and that fills their lives up with meaning. And we just ask people to share those little moments where they're doing something that they think is really special and they think adds to their world, might add to our worlds as well, who knows. But these are just little bits of people's lives that make us relevant and make life relevant to them. That's why they give them airtime. Instead of running a commercial to sell a product, we run love commercials to sell an idea.
Okay.
You'll hear them. If you listen to our loop, you'll hear love commercials on a regular basis. They're just 5-10 seconds long. Anybody listening could submit theirs through the you can go to the website, theworkfm.org. There's a comment button. You could send a love commercial through that. And there's other ways, but that's a simple way to do it.
Okay.
So, yeah, send them in. Let us know what makes the world fun. What makes life worthwhile. Things like doing these shows.
Right. All right. I believe we... I want to share about the funding for us. Community is affected by the 2020 census.
Yeah, the census.
Yes.
That's right. We got to take part in that.
Every person deserves to be counted, and our community is counting on you. The United States Constitution requires that a census be conducted every 10 years. And I believe that 10th year is this year, right?
That's right.
And it's data about our nation, about the people, the places, and the economy. And census data is used to make decisions at the federal, state, and local level of government.
How much budget they send to your state and your county and your community.
Like local level, data from census help determine where the new schools and roads and public facilities are built.
Very important.
State level, the census affect policy decisions made by a legislator and funding for public service such as education, health care, and economy development. This fit in right in with our little fashion show that we're going to have. You know what I'm saying?
I've heard is that they might not come door to door with the coronavirus around, but there's a way you can answer the census online.
Okay.
And I think April 1st is the day They expect it to start at your doors or on online, mm-hmm. start collecting information from everyone.
Mm-hmm. Mm, okay. The federal level, the census impact Virginia budgets for essential programs like Medicaid, SNAP, highways, transportation, education, child care programs, food stamps, and affordable housing. And 2016, Virginia received over $17 billion through the 55 federal spending program. Explain that. What does that mean?
Does that pay for the schools?
It just said $17 billion through 55 federal spending programs. I guess it's 55.
It's probably highways and airports and schools and lunch programs and all.
Oh, that's what I wanted to share with you. They closed the schools, but they do have the food that will still be given out.
The lunch program.
Mm-hmm.
Great.
Yeah, so that still would be given out. So, but how would the students get to it?
Good question.
So I guess we need to find out. I mean, since I really don't have any students, you know, per se, my children are outgrown, you know what I'm saying? So parents, how would your children get to that
mm-hmm.
unless they're bringing it into the community, you know?
Maybe the churches would distribute it then or something.
That could be it. And, I think the churches need to get more active involved in helping the needed and the poor. How can we do that? How can we get our churches more active for those who need and in need? I mean, we have these big mega churches.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm pretty sure they take care of their community.
And they're all tax exempt. Mm-hmm. Too. They're not paying any taxes on those billions that they might make in a year.
So how do we get these churches involved with the special needs that is in the community, especially down there in Intense Center? Oh, I talked to Rhonda Sneed, and she told me that there was 89 tents down there. 89 tents, and the youngest that they have is started, I believe she said started 19,
so,
and go all the way up to 81.
What is the city's plan?
I told you they was opening up
the building on Wednesdays.
Uh-huh, and it's only for a few hours. I'm making a comparison now. You gonna have to forgive me, but I have to put it out there. How can Dominion help? I mean, it's still negotiating with Mayor Stoney in building the
mm-hmm.
the Navy Hill project.
No, I think it's been killed officially.
That been killed?
Officially, yeah.
Okay.
Well, so how can you get him to help with things that really matter?
Yeah, how can we get them to help with things that really matter? If that been killed, so where they going to put that billions now?
Well, the money mm-hmm. didn't exist. They were asking for the money. It didn't exist.
Okay.
They had investors who were waiting to invest in it.
So where are those investors now?
Yeah, we could use an investor or two.
They're looking for cash. They're not looking for community growth or development or empowerment of the population, especially the ones who don't have any money. They're looking for money. They're looking for cheap land from the city, looking for opportunism rather than progress. I think you'd have to find a different set of investors if you want progress and not just profit.
Okay. So how can we go about that? Finding the ones who want progress instead of profit to be able to help as far as with
the homeless.
The homeless, mm-hmm. yeah. So how can we do that? Is there anybody out there that, you know, have an answer to that, that can be able to? And, you know, we welcome any suggestions, and just call in.
Mm-hmm. We'll talk about it.
We'll talk about it. See how we can be able to bring a change in people's lives. You know, because that's what we need, and that's our goal. We are trying to reach out and do a change. Oh, I want to share with you about the dismantle the education pipeline to jail that I went to on this past week at the Martin Luther King.
Middle school.
And they had some very good. They had Angela Davis' sister there speaking, and she was quite. She bought a program. In fact, she bought the program that she was talking about was the one that the Unitarian Church was presenting. Mm-hmm. Restoration Justice.
Mm.
Yeah.
Restorative justice.
Yeah, mm-hmm. Restored justice. And that's what she was talking about. How they have gotten, they receive a lot of money to do that restoration justice where she is. So, but that still doesn't include the other things that the people need.
Mm-hmm.
You see what I'm saying? It, to me, it was a good start, but it was one-sided. So they were saying how most of our students, and we already know this, are sent through the pipeline to jail because of bullying. They even say that one of the features was the hair. Remember we had that talk about the hair?
And the hoodies.
Uh-huh. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And all of these are little nonsense stuff that really shouldn't matter when it comes around to giving these children, our children, the safe environment for learning.
Mm-hmm.
What does your hairstyle have anything to do with learning? Come on.
Mm-hmm.
So I asked the parents. I said, y'all all agree on one thing. Our community need healing. And our community do need healing.
Mm-hmm.
But how do you involve the community into help writing the school policy that affect our children when they end up into the pipeline to jail?
Mm-hmm.
I couldn't, that's when they brought out about the, they trying to get things, trying to get the legislator to pass about the hair. And I was going, that has nothing to do with what I just asked. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
So one of them did say, well, you can, The parents can be able to, if they're interested, they can be able to give their grievances to the school board and help bring about change. I said, so, I said, and you know me, I said, well, did y'all know that? But that was something that I had spoken on last week. Remember?
Mm-hmm.
Remember I had spoken that to Tatiana?
Mm-hmm.
How they can be able to, the students can be able to go and
start a group of leadership, be
yes.
good examples.
Uh-huh, mm-hmm. uh-huh. And mm-hmm. that's what I had shared. So I asked the parents who were there, I said, did any of you know that? You know? And so it didn't many of the hands go up, you know? And then she made it just a comment, if you really care, you know. So. But afterward, it did draw a response from the vice president of the Richmond School Board, and her name is Cheryl Burke. She called me to the side later, and she said, I want to get with you so that we can be able to talk about that.
Good.
So that respond, you see what I'm saying? Brought forth.
It reached her.
Mm-hmm. It reached her, mm-hmm. and she mm-hmm. is in position to do something about that. So that is one of the things I'm going to take up, and I'm going to get her involved with this. Building better societies. Because we want to meet and talk with people that we know can make a difference and who will have an interest.
You know, I was at the Women's March last Sunday.
Okay. I didn't get to go there.
And they were celebrating the ERA,
right.
The passage of the ERA for Virginia. Mm-hmm. And I was telling Ron, I think every state should add to their constitution the Equal Rights Amendment.
Mm-hmm.
And then instead of having to wait for the federal government to get their act together,
mm-hmm.
each state would already have in place what's important to them, which is treating mm-hmm. all genders with respect.
Respect. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And before the march started, they had a few speakers mm-hmm. at the Monroe Park.
Mm-hmm.
One of them was the great, 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 I don't remember how many greats, granddaughter mm-hmm. of Maggie Walker.
Mm-hmm.
And she was a very eloquent young lady, and she said how pleased her ancestor would have been to mm-hmm. see how far women had gone, although it had taken much longer than necessary.
Right.
Mm. And then they marched down. It was very organized. The group in front wore white. They were the women suffragettes, the ones that had, they represented in their costumes the women who had fought for the right to vote.
Mm-hmm.
The second one was the group wearing red. Third was a group wearing purple and then blue and then the stragglers, which I was, in the back. So they marched to the Capitol building.
Mm-hmm.
Had a large photo taken and then marched back down to Monroe Park. Mm-hmm. There were those big puppets,
mm-hmm.
those big tall ones, and mm-hmm. then there was someone on stilts, and there were some men there. And
many?
Maybe not many,
mm-hmm.
but it was good to see
quite
any men there.
Mm-hmm. Quite a few.
And there were a lot
did
of...
Did you go wrong?
I was there, yeah.
There were a lot of young girls there, little girls.
Little girls.
Yeah, it was sweet to see them all dressed up and holding their posters and
that's
marching
precious.
Along. Mm-hmm.
So what you saw was mothers, great-grandmothers, and daughters, and great-great-great-grandchildren, maybe?
Yeah.
Okay.
There were all
ages, all size, all colors. Mm-hmm.
Not enough of all colors.
Not enough of what?
They were mostly white people, and mm-hmm. I wondered at the time, you know, where are all our African-American sisters?
Okay.
Because there weren't many.
Uh-huh.
But there was one couple, two women, older women. One of them was dressed like a nun, so I assumed she was a nun.
Mm-hmm.
And they were older. And I would love to have taken their picture and interviewed them, but I couldn't think of a polite way to do it.
You needed me to be there with
you. Yes, you should have been there. Yeah, but they represented all ages, all walks of life coming to celebrate this.
Yes. Okay. All right. Gotcha. Okay. How about that? And let's get back to the census. So what it said, a complete count in Virginia benefits all of us. However, our state is at risk of being undercounted.
Mm-hmm.
So they said, join us to make sure that Virginia counts. So what do we do? Where is Virginia counts? How do we get in contact that? The Virginia Counts Coalition is committed to ensuring an accurate and representative census count with a focus on historically undercount populations. Through our outreach effort, we strive to uplift communities of color low-income communities, immigrant communities, and families with children under the age of 5.
Mm-hmm.
So in order to get involved, what we have to do is email Alex.
You know, I'm not sure where it stands right now, because with the coronavirus, some things will be changed.
Mm-hmm.
There won't be as many people going door to door.
Mm-hmm.
So.
Yes, true. I don't know how they're going to do that.
Okay.
Computer.
If those people who do have access to a computer maybe could help work with a family, helping them get their information on.
Mm-hmm. Okay, we got another announcement, and that's our RVA Voices from the Holy Land. And this is St. Thomas Episcopal Church, and it is presenting Imprisoning a Generation. Imprisoning a Generation is a documentary film following the story of 4 young Palestinians who have been detained and imprisoned under the Israel military and political system. Their perspective, along with the voices of their family, combined to form a lens into the entangled structure of oppression that has spanned well beyond the prison walls. This is Sunday, March the 29th, 2020, from 2 o'clock to 4:30 p.m. Public invited, and it's free. And this is at St. Thomas Episcopal Church, 3602 Hawthorne Avenue, Richmond, Virginia. And they said that light snacks will be served.
And what was the time of day again?
The time of day is March the 29th, 2 o'clock to 4:30 p.m.
It sounds like a very worthwhile movie.
It does.
We mm-hmm. hear a lot about Israel, but we don't hear much about what happens to the Palestinians.
Mm-hmm.
As Israel, the government of Israel has more Palestinian homes bulldozed down.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I heard that. Yes, yes.
30 seconds.
Okay. I guess we'll wrap this up. Sandy, thank you for being my wonderful guest. And of course, Ron, thank you.
Woo-hoo!
What would we say?
I practically live here.
How much we would say he put 2 cents?
His 2 cents in? He put his 2 cents in?
He put a couple dollars
in. That reminds me, we always need donations here at the station.
That's right.
Keep the lights on.
But until next Saturday, you have been listening to Building Better Societies. Today was very interesting, and we cover a lot of grounds. But until next Saturday, goodbye.
Well, thank you very much, Liz. Great show. And, well, we're going to move back to our loop, which is going to start in a couple of seconds. And glad you joined us here on WRWK LP FM 93.9 FM, The Work FM, serving and licensed in Midlothian, but also serving Chesterfield, Henrico, Richmond, Goochland, Hanover, and the entire internet universe. So, getting back to our loop. Yes, here you go.
Clowns to the left of me, jokers to the right, here I am, stuck in the middle with you.
Yep.
Yes, I'm stuck in the middle with you.
From Pacifica Radio in Los Angeles, this is The Bradcast, as heard on KPFK 90.7 FM in LA, where it is raining. Will that wash all?